Let's talk about Knockout.js, the organizational library we'll be using in this lesson. Now, since Knockout is an organizational library, we'll get most of the same things we've talked about before. Models, views, and octopus, but they don't call it octopus. In Knockout, it's called a view model. If you go to knockoutjs.com, you'll find a whole bunch of information here, including some of these unfamiliar terms. Let's spend a minute unpacking some of these terms. First, we have view model. The view model is similar to the octopus that we know and love. It's the thing that connects and separates the model from the view. The main difference for now is the name. Also keep in mind that the word view model is one word in this case. So when we say MVVM, VM represents one term, not two. The model, the view, and the view model. Next, we have declarative bindings. Up until now, you've been connecting your DOM elements with your data in the model by writing code in the octopus. And probably there have been a few times that it seemed especially tedious. A lot of the methods that we write in the octopus end up doing the same old thing, simply passing a value this way or this way. Now, rather than write all of that tedious logic in the octopus or the view model, Knockout lets you connect these two using bindings that you put in the HTML. Now, it's important to point out that it still is going through the view model to get the data. We are not connecting things directly. The difference here is that instead of writing a bunch of code in the octopus or the view model, which goes and grabs portions of the view, we're going the opposite way. We're putting the logic in the DOM in the form of bindings. We'll get into them in more detail in just a moment. But suffice it to say that bindings are a great way to make the connections between the view and the view model without writing a lot of repetitive functions that ultimately do the same thing manually. Next, we have automatic UI refresh. UI stands for user interface, and Knockout will watch your model data and automatically refresh the view when it changes. Effectively, that's some of our octopus code that Knockout is responsible for doing automatically. And if you set up the right declarative bindings in your DOM, Knockout will actually watch things in your view, like input boxes, and automatically update the model when view stuff changes. Sometimes that's called two-way binding. And lastly, we have dependency tracking. Sometimes your model data depends on other model data. For example, if we were to get our clicked cats levels, which increase as the cats get more clicks, the level data, right here, would depend on the clicks data. Knockout lets us create that relationship where one model depends on another, and will automatically track those dependencies for us and update things accordingly. So these four terms are some of the important new terms that you probably should know if you're working with Knockout.js. And in fact, if you ever pick up a new framework, always go to the website and look for these kinds of terms that you don't already know and figure out what they mean. Usually the concepts, once you think of them in English, are not very hard. Now, in terms of these last three, they'll make even more sense once we do it ourselves.